Hello, I am Florian Godard from Creative Media. In this tutorial, I will show you how to edit my templates with Final Cut Pro 10. Open Final Cut Pro 10 and start with a new project. Click on the generator sidebar icon. Open the generator's drop-down menu and search for your templates. If you copy-paste the template files, they should be placed in the custom folder. Click and drag the template in the timeline. Choose 30 frames per second and click OK. You can find on the right part of the screen the published parameters that allow you to customize your video. Let's start by unchecking the instruction notes and advance in the timeline to have an overview of your template. Then stop on a frame that displays many footage. To import your footage, go back in the library sidebar and click on a project. Then select and import your files. Click on the template and go back in the published parameters. We will start to replace the media placeholders with your footage. Click on Media 1 placeholder and select your footage. Repeat the operation with Media 2, 3 and 4. Once you have finished, click on Apply Clip. If the Apply Clip button is missing, you can press the Enter key. As you can see, the animation is now updated with your footage. To edit your texts, click on the generator and go back to the published parameters. You will see multiple text zones. You can edit your texts and it will instantly update the animation. Now, let's add your logo. Select Source Clip and click on your logo. Then, Apply Clip. As you can see, the logo needs adjustments. Below the logo placeholder, you will find pan or position controls and a scale slider. You can modify these parameters to adjust your logo. Finally, most of templates include color customization options. Click on a color parameter, this will open the color palette selection tool. Then, when you pick a different color, you can instantly view the result. When you have finished to edit your animation, here is how to export your video. In the File menu, click on Share and select Master File. In the Settings panel, be sure to select Video and Audio. I recommend to use a H.264 codec. Click on Next, edit your file name and change folder if needed. You can check the export progression in the Background Task panel. I hope this tutorial has been helpful for you. Thank you for watching.